giving me a wave offering wherever you are. Giving me a wave offering. It is an act of worship commanded by God. Giving me a wave offering. Thank you, Lord. Father, we are waving unto you as an appreciation that we know that you are there. As an appreciation of all what you have done. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' mighty name, we are waiting. Let's open our mouth and pray and say, Father, thank you for all your children you have used. We anoint and reward them. Thank you for all your children that you have used. Re-anoint and reward them. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Say, Father, thank you for the gift of life. Thank you for his sound mind. Thank you for your mercies. Thank you for your numerous blessings. Thank you for the victory that I'm not even aware of. Thank you for the deliverances, many of which I don't even know. Thank you, open your mouth and just give thanks. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. For all you have done in my life, we are so blessed.
We are so blessed.
Our souls are found blessed.
Our souls are found.
Loving you, and you are not expressing. The thing that is the basic normal human thing. So if somebody is not now doing that one is not even below self. But they're not standing on the height of love. That even when we were yet sinner, when we were not showing him love, he still loved us. That is why you should be grateful. Say, Father, thank you for your unconditional love towards me. I don't know about you, but towards me, God has shown me that unconditional love. Even when I'm not faithful, he's faithful. Even when I'm not consistent, he's consistently showing me mercy. Thank you. Thank you. I am grateful. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. You are moving from glory to glory. Therefore, yesterday we said some things that we need to embrace to move from glory to glory. Number one, prayer and praise. Number two, plan and prepare. Number three, don't just think and plan. Do it. I like that. Do it. Then number four, be consistent. Number five, think big. I'm going to be praying about some other, and then you know God told us that we are going from glory to glory. And people will be excited, hey, glory. But I don't be told us on 2 days ago, that is good though to be excited about the word that God has released for any month, any year. But a mature believer will ask this critical question: what must I do? Because there is a path for any blessing of God that must manifest. There is no one path. If you don't do your part, it's just a mirage, you just heard the word. And somebody that knows how to maximize his own path or own path, they share the same word with them. But one is rising, one is not rising. That's why people say that the sower of the seed went out to sow, and he dropped good seed on good ground, though. But how come? There are some questions that may I ask anytime I read scripture. Maybe that is why, because it is who that acts that will be told. If you don't knock, it will not open. When you read and you just read thoughtlessly and pass, no revelation for you. But when you get to some point, why? Why is it that good seeds falling on good ground bringing 30, 60, 100? I don't understand it. It should be bringing forth the same thing. But it's the attitude in which you receive the word. That is how some people among us, we are not blessed the same. Among us, we don't carry the same grace. Among us, yet the same one will come. The difference is the attitude in which you receive the word and the level of the doing of the word. Simple, it will just make, even though we receive the same word, but some will just rise to 30, some will move to 60, and some will get ungrateful. What are the things that you need to do to move you from glory? You know, our services are very, very short. So we use every opportunity that I have to keep on teaching you, apart from those 5 points, to keep on teaching you some things that you need to embrace or refrain from embracing that will move you from glory to glory. There are some things that you should not allow to control you. Number one of those things that you should not allow to control you. Which one should I even talk about first? Don't allow your past to control you. You will not move from glory to glory if you allow your past failure, your past disappointment, your past any negative thing. Some people, their past is the one controlling them. When Jesus Christ got to Peter in Luke chapter 5, 4 to 6, Peter had toiled all night. He had sailed. He did not catch a single fish.
Now
it's a new month.
Now it's a new season. Now it's a new day.
Jesus Christ said that, please launch out into the deep. He was referring to the past. I have toiled all night. I have worked. Thank God for God helping him to still just do. Even he did it reluctantly because he just threw one net. Never allow your past to control you. Now when he had left speaking, he said unto Simon, launch out into the deep and let down your nets for a drought. And Simon also said unto him, Master, we have toiled all the night past and have taken nothing. Nevertheless, at thy word, I will let down the net. Single. And when they had this done, they include a great multitude of fishes, and their nets break. If not that God just showed him mercy, his past failure was about to control him not to do what he needed to do. One thing you should not allow to control is your past. In the book of John chapter 5, when you read, I think from 5 to 9, John 5, there was a particular man that had been going through a situation for 38 years. The Bible said that the angel will come to stir the water at the particular time. The person that will draw, fall into the water first, will be healed of whatsoever disease. And this man had tried, but no way. When Jesus Christ came, without being made up, he kept on referring, I have nobody to help me. But now you have the greatest help with you. But the past is not controlling you from seizing the greatest opportunity that is standing before you. Never allow your past to control you. And the Sunday man was there, which had an infirmity 30 and 80 years. When Jesus saw him lying, I knew that he had been now a long time. I don't know whether he had been in that situation for a long time. In that case, he said unto him, will I be made whole? Then the impotent man answered him, sir, I have no man. When the water is troubled to put me into the pool, but while I am coming, another stepped down before me. Jesus said unto him, right! Up thy bed and walk. And immediately the man was made whole and took up his bed and walked. And on the same day was the Sabbath. He was about to allow his past failure, his past no connection. Now he was having a man, not just a man, he was having a God. God a man standing before him. He was about to allow what he had gone through. In the book of Isaiah chapter 43, I think 18, he said that, remember what not the former thing. Don't allow your past to control you. Remember ye not the former things, neither consider the things of old. 19. Say that, behold, just see what I'm about to do. Behold, I'm doing a new thing. Now it shall spring forth. Shall ye not know it? I will even make a way in the wilderness and rivers in the desert. 1 point. I will be giving you an examination. Now, I'm giving you an examination for what did I say 2 days ago? And you gave me the 5 points. Be remembering all these ones now. Things you will not allow to control you. Number one, your past. Open your mouth and pray and say, Father, please help me. And never to allow my past to control me. So that I will keep on moving from glory to glory. Help me and let me not let my past control me. Help me not to allow my past. My past failure, past disappointment, past instability to control me. Thank you, Lord. Let me not allow my past to control me. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Number two,
their pedigree, where they are from. You should know something in the scripture, that something bad, or I would like to put it, let me put it the other way, something good can be brought out of a bad place. Jesus Christ showed us that example in the book of John chapter 1, 45 and 46. Nathanael was saying, can any good thing, even if your place is very poor, you are from a poor family, they did not even have money to send you to school, you can rise to be the greatest with God in you and with you. Philip findeth Nathanael and said unto him, we have found him of whom Moses in the law and the prophet did write, Jesus of Nazareth, the son of Joseph. And Nathanael said unto him, can there any good thing come out of Nazareth? Philip said unto him, what did he say? Come and see, you. Even he came from me, that place is a bad or what place? The Savior, Jesus Christ, is coming from there. Is it true? And he's not telling you, don't allow your pedigree to control you. Don't allow your lineage, your family history, or whatever happened. It happened to them, it will not happen to you. You will break the genes, the curse that is in your family. Open your mouth and pray and say, Father, Father, please help me never to allow my pedigree to limit me, to control me, to slow me down, to stop me. Help me never to allow my pedigree to limit me, to control me, to slow me down. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Aka akaya, aka jioba nemena.
Connection that you have. When if you are a child of God, you have the resources of heaven.
that cannot be physically seen, that can be moved to any hand and to any situation to settle your being. But God will make it sometimes not visible. So don't say, this out is too big for me. This project, you don't just make up your mind to do things that are just beneath you. There are some projects, once you are led by God, even as a pastor, that many projects that we have done in this house, we didn't have the money. But I have known some things. I would not have risen to where I am if it's based on only what I have, what I'm seeing, that is determining the project. This is the next project we are doing. This is the next project. This is how we are going to be defined. You will never see. But you should know that you are worth more than it seems you are. By the time you launch into the project, you just start seeing your rewards. The money start appearing. The favor start appearing. The open doors start appearing. God is trying to keep you safe by locking them up in the spiritual realm. It's just for you to now make up your mind, this is what I'm going to do. I'm going to do this level of celebration. This level of something, the money will appear. That is how it is. And there are some things, in another way, you should not allow money to determine what you will give in to. There are some things that in your life, they are not for sale. That's why I said that don't allow your boss. Not for sale. Don't read the book of 1 Kings chapter 21 from 1 to 3. 1 Kings 21, 1 to 3. King Ahab went to name Naboth. He said, I need your vineyard because it is close to my palace. Give it to me and I will give you a better one and I will give you the money's worth. He said, I'm not going to sell it to you even though you are a king. It is my inheritance and I'm not going to sell my inheritance. That word is pregnant. There are some things that are not for sale. Your anointing is not for sale. Your integrity is not for sale. Your body is not for sale. I can keep on mentioning things, but this scripture does tell you no. Even though you want to give me, I'm not going to relinquish this one. Money cannot buy this. And it came to pass after this thing that Naboth the Jezreelite had a vineyard which was in Jezreel, had by the palace of Ahab the king of Samaria. And Ahab spake unto Naboth, saying, give me thy vineyard that I may have it for a garden of herbs, because it is near unto my house, and I will give thee for it a better vineyard than it. Or if it seem good to thee, I will give thee the worth of it in money. 3. And Naboth said to Ahab, Ahab the king, the Lord forbid it me that I should give the inheritance of my fathers unto thee. And from that scripture, I coined out a statement in my heart since I gave my life to Christ. There are some things in your life that are not for sale. Your integrity is not for sale. Your body is not for sale. Your faith is not for sale. There are some things I can sell, but this one, devil, you, I'm not going to relinquish it to you. Don't allow us to control you. Open your mouth and pray and say, Father, Father, please help me. Never allow purse or money to control every decision that will limit my moving from glory to glory. In the name of Jesus, don't allow that. Mashallah, Baba, make it stay deliver. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Let me just tell you one, because of our time. The first thing I said that you should not allow to control you when you want to move from glory to glory is what? Your past. Number two thing,
pedigree.
Your pedigree. Number three thing,
wow.
The number four thing, your people. People can delay, and guess what? They can be your own people. Never allow people to stop you from rising high. I say your people because that is why this message is very, very sensitive. And People that love you can delay you. You have not heard this kind of message before, but I'm telling you, as your father in the Lord, I have the responsibility of telling you the truth so that you will be armed with it and you will be able to glide through this life safely, even in the midst of so many crooked things in the world. Not that they meant this for evil, go and ask Jesus versus Peter. Peter received from God. Jesus Christ was saying that, who do men say that I am? In Matthew chapter 16, I think 17 and 18. Who do men say that I am? Some people say different wrong things, but Peter got it right. And Jesus said that flesh and blood have not revealed this to you, but my Father in heaven. He got it right. It's his people. His people. But guess what? Down the line, verse 22 and 23, Jesus Christ said that he was going to the cross to die. He was going to pay this ultimate price. This is the assignment God had given unto him. The same Peter grabbed him, said that you will not go. You will not go to the cross. You will not go and die. Jesus Christ looked at him and said that, get you behind me, Satan. You want to stop me from this attack? Because God used you for, the person God used for you, the devil is interested in using against you. Get that clear now. I'm not saying that you should be suspecting anyone, but be sensitive. If person may not know, be sensitive. Guess what brought down King Saul? The people God used to bless him once upon a time. In the book of 1 Samuel chapter 10, 26, 1 Samuel chapter 10, when he became a king, the Bible said that God touched the hearts of some people, they followed him. All those same people, when God told him in 1 Samuel chapter 15, 1 to 3, go and kill all the Amalekites. He did not kill some. When Samuel came, he said, why did you not kill? I'm hearing cattle, I'm hearing. He said that it's the people that are with me. They chose those ones that are with me. The people that God used to bless most of all the time, you are now insensitive. When they are now bringing suggestion and people bring suggestion and opinion to you. It's not that there are many good people that have brought many in their heart of heart. They wish me well. But at that time that they are bringing that suggestion, I sign that it was not of God. It all sometimes may not be Satan, it will be fleshy. I just thank you. I just sit it away with you. Keep on moving. You want to go from glory to glory? Never allow your past. Never allow your pedigree. Never allow your boss. Never even allow your people. Some people would allow yours, they will not agree with some of your decisions. If God had led you in that area, just keep going. Romans chapter 3:3-4. Romans chapter 3. What if some do not believe? With their unbelief, make the faith of God without effect. God forbid, let God be true, and every man, every family member, every pastor, everyone, if this is what God has led you to do, go ahead, do it. And you see that they will say, come and rejoice with you because you move from glory to glory. Open your mouth and pray and say, Father, please help me. Never allow people to slow me down or to stop me as I move from glory to glory. After that, don't begin to bless the name of the Lord. Thank him for answered prayers. Also pray for your land. Say, let me be well with this land. Prosper this land. Help our leaders to do the right things. And help me to make it to heaven in the fullness of my time, gloriously and with ease, alongside with my loved ones and friends. In Jesus' mighty name we are praying. Father, thank you for this few moments. We will have a lot to keep on praying, but because of time. Therefore, all the things that we will have prayed, there is no time to pray. Father, do it for us in the name of Jesus. Everyone that is here and everyone that is online, Father, before the end of today, let there be a divine visitation. At the end of the divine visitation, let us do so many celebrations. So shall it be. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Father, give us a song and we give up. All the things that you are helping us to deal with, let them be permanently dealt with in our life. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen. God bless you. Please be seated. If this is your first time of coming to worship with us on a morning service like this, when you
We love you wherever you are. You can wave your hand to Jesus Christ. We can online your time first time. We are with this Redeemed Church of the Lord, Kingsway Palace area, 101, Lagos Ministry Region 19. Here, holiness is our watchword. Evangelism and sprinkles and excellence are way of life. Please keep coming and God will keep blessing you. Later today, we are going to be having faith clinic. I will just keep on continuing with the things that can stop a person. I'm sensing one thing that I must talk about this evening. Don't miss it though. If you miss it, at this point, you'll be keeping them and be reciting them. What are the first 5.2? What are the first next 1.2? And be watchful. Pray them into your life and you see that they come out before the end of this month that you will not move to different levels of glory higher. So it's a clinic later tonight. And tomorrow is Holy Ghost speaking session, 25 hour. And also, later in the day, we'll be having the Holy Ghost service virtual, and you can also physically be there. Choose your choice. Then, day after that, the GEO is on Saturday, and it's at 10 a.m. The people that are registered online, just connect through the link. You know, there is a special link for anyone that registered with money. Of course, it's with money. I believe that maybe it will still be available. Register with money. When you enter into it, you will see the amount that is there. Let me not tell you the amount that you will register with. So you will see the amount and with your card, your Visa card or ATM card, you'll be able to do, and they'll give you your code, and that he will send a present to you or they give to you later. Big Fedo present worship with the King 1.0. It will be on the 20th day of this month, and various people will be ministering alongside with him. Oyekachukwu Nkem, Fred, Simon Shodi, Tonya, Omar, Prophet Isom, Michael Okoro, Reverend Dr. Ifeanyi Maxwell, Madwe KC, Pastor Tukumo Shibuluwa, will be ministering, and God will be blessing us through all of them in the name of Jesus. I want to appreciate all the people that have been giving to us church planting. God will keep on increasing you on all sides in the name of Jesus. Reminder for foot, nose mask, or face mask when you are coming here. Birthday celebration. If your birthday is today, happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday. Happy birthday to you. This year will be your best year so far in your own life story in the name of Jesus. Come on, so I feel that just say, Father, thank you. Thank you because nothing will prevent me from moving from glory to glory. Nothing. Not my past. Not my pedigree. Not my boss. Not people. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. I decree into your life injection to become unstoppable. Let it be granted unto you. The wisdom to rise, let it be injected into you. The favor to keep on gliding where other people are struggling, let it be released unto you. It shall be well with you. I cover your life and destiny with the blood of Jesus. So shall it be. In Jesus' mighty name we are praying. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ. And the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen. Surely, God goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our life. And we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. Let somebody shout hallelujah. K and peace.